I still look very young, right? Uh-huh. 16.
Racism is only a limitation to people who are not producing outstanding results. Mm. You cannot be producing results and someone with a different skin color will push you aside. I remember when I was coming from Nigeria, I told them that, look, I'm not coming back to this country until I become a full professor. And I gave them a deadline. If I don't become a full professor, at least I must be an associate professor before I come back to this country. And I said, I give you just 10 years. Maximum 10 years from 2012. I've been here for 6.5 years. Maximum 10 years. And we have spent 6.5 of 10. How many do we have left? 3.5. Okay. Last week, I became a doctor, official doctor, last week, about 2 weeks ago, there about. A full doctor in the university. And I still look very young, right? Uh-huh. 16. So, and I collected a list. What does it take to be an associate prof? From where I am? Mm. They said you need just about 3 or 4 years to do that. And then they gave me a list of it. And I told them, I said, look, in 2 years, because I have a deadline I'm working for, in 2 years, mm-hmm. I will be an associate prof. They're like, it's not possible. If nobody has done that here, you can't. Say, you just watch.
All right.
You just watch. And when people tell you you cannot do it, that's what you tell them. You just watch me. You just keep watching. So you have to get to a point where you carry yourself like a celebrity. You move like a celebrity. You think like a celebrity. Don't sleep like a normal human being would sleep. Sleep like a celebrity. How do they sleep? You don't know.
Yes. Celebrities. Like who in the world?
Celebrities.
Sleepless.
They spend little time sleeping.
Yeah.
They have everything and then they spend more time awake thinking of how they will acquire what you have. You that don't have much. Do you understand what I'm talking about? They have everything. But while you are sleeping, they stay awake thinking of who can grow to be a competition. And they think and devise how they will acquire that person. And they keep acquiring so that they will be the only one dominating and in charge of things. So you can't afford to be sleeping anyhow. You sleep 8 hours in a day. That may look okay. But I'm telling you, 8 hours in a day for a student, that's way too much. You don't think so?
It's too much.
It's just way too much. Even when I was a teenager, very small boy, maximum 5-6 hours I sleep. Even that one is too much. One of the teachers I had when I was going there with Bishop Oyedepo. If this is like he doesn't sleep, when he's walking, you think he's sleeping when he's walking. How many people have seen him talk before? You will see his eyes very heavy like this. He has not slept, you know. So the idea is they find time to rest, no doubt about that. Yeah. They find time to relax. But you see, the way they sleep is not the way a common man sleeps.
Yeah.
The way they walk is not the way a common man walks. The way they get their things done is not the way common men do their things. You are not a common human being. Can you even tell somebody? You are not a common person. You are uncommon. You are unusual. You are not a common person. And unless psychology sinks, you may end up still doing things the way everybody is doing it. All right, number four. Racism is not a valid excuse for lack of performance. The day you begin to believe that it is because of the color of your skin that you are limited, that's the day you begin to lose your identity. You are too much for the color of your skin. The color on your skin it can never be your limitation. Racism is only a limitation to people who are not producing outstanding results. You cannot be producing results and someone with a different skin color will push you aside. You can't be solving their problems that they don't have solutions to, and they will say because you are black, they don't need your solution. As a matter of fact, they will buy you. Yes. They will offer you anything they can pay you and take it to their country. Yes. That's to let you know that racism is the least of your problems. Look at the world of sports. Haven't you seen black people in the world of sports that are making things happen?
Yes, every day is a forecast.
Even Obama became a president as a black man, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
But I'm going to do one about Obama. Do you believe it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You know how?
Little sleep.
I don't want to be president of the United States of America. I am going to be a coach, a mentor, to whoever the president is when I come.
Just a matter of time.
So, racism is not a valid excuse for lack of performance. You have to start stepping up your game to begin to produce outstanding results in everything that you do. Once you can produce results, people are going to run after you. people are going to come for you. People are going to even beg you.
Yes, sir.
Once you can produce results, that yes, is sir. What people need. Not all too much talk, talk,
talk.
Produce results.
Fuck is cheap, sir.
Produce results. If you're a businessman, produce results.
Yes, sir.
If you're a pastor, ah, I love what pastor, pastor, you know, I got to know him through Imo. I mean, if you know Imo.
Yes, sir.
Imo has put on the money.
Exactly.
And Imo was always telling me, ah, there is one man of God, bro. He just came, he just, that guy is taking over the island, though. I think this service used to be in
City
Royale. Yeah. That used to be under the tree, but now the guy is using a hotel. I want to meet this guy. I want to see this guy. I want to meet him and see him. You know, he's running things and he's pushing. He has results. And we have a long-standing plan for a relationship that I don't even know how to turn out. But I'm telling you very soon. Watch out.
Very true, sir.
Just as I said,
watch out.
Look at my face.
Very true.
Look at my face, baby. Look at my face. Look at my face. My face is coming soon. Very soon. It's coming.
Yes, sir.
Very true.
My face is coming.
Very true. Okay.
Number five. The nightmare called selling is your daybreak to success. Selling is one of the most difficult things for many young people in today's generation. Not is it only difficult, it is also not understood by many people in our generation. And so many people don't give you the attention that it should be given. Selling, I have never seen. This is Millionaire's Club, and I'm happy that we are all together again.
Yes,
we are all going to make history and
great
things. So, but the idea is, there has never been, you can search the history of time. There has never been any billionaire who is not a master at selling.
Mm.
If he's not a master at selling, he has a master at selling as his employee.
Mm.
He go check it out. So if you are not selling, it will be too difficult for you to become anything you want to become financially. And the first question is, how do you sell? And then it's, what do you sell? Every time. Every moment you have, as you are sitting before me like this, you can be selling. As I'm talking to you here, I am selling. So I don't have to come again the next time.
Selling your market. Right now, sir, wood bag.
So the idea is every opportunity you have is an opportunity to do what?
To sell.
So you must be selling. I don't know how you will be a papa. You are cutting here and nobody knows that you are cutting here. How do you want to succeed? And only one or two people in your room just got four. How can you be involved in currency exchange? You are involved in what else they do? Plating air.
Yeah.
They also cook for people now and they do buy it. You are doing all of those things. And people don't know. The world does not know that you do those things.
Mm-hmm.
How do you want to make it?
No selling point.
How? When I remember as I was going on, one of the teachers I met told me, he said, look, boy, anything you are doing, make noise. Just make your noise.
Mm-hmm.
Those who don't want to hear will block their ears, but you keep making the noise.
Yes.
Just keep making. And
yeah, Patra, I listen to you.
Abi, I don't know if you know Patra here. When we started here, they told us, boy, that I just wasted time. Anytime we have a meeting, of even 3 people, mm-hmm. or just 5 executives, the way I announce it on Facebook, you would think it's the whole world that is coming for the meeting.
Definitely, sir.
And I'm not doing that because I just want to be on the Facebook or social media or anything. I am doing that because I am working on the psychology of people.
Yes.
And very soon, the president of this country will invite me to come on.
Definitely.
You just watch.
That is possible.
You just watch.
It's already happening.
So the idea is you have to keep selling all the time.
Yes, sir.
All the time. Yes. You know how to write, you know how to sing, you know how to act, you know how to do this. You have to let the world know that you can do these things.
Yes, sir.
I can make that my last point, sir, right?
Thank you very much, sir.
Add one more, sir.
Don't let that
go. Sorry, sir. One more, sir.
Pastor won't invite me again the next time, but I add one more. Don't spoil my market, too. Don't spoil my market, too.
More, sir.